Alright, what's up guys? Yogizilla here. We're doing Metro Friday on a Saturday. Metro Friday's it's just a brand. We do it when we feel like it. We're doing it today on Saturday. About to play a gigantic beta. The last stress test of the closed beta, supposedly. I think I played this a little bit yesterday. We did Madden. And everything. Well, that's not retro. Like, well, Madden hasn't really changed in over a decade. And we have a similar thing here with Yu-Gi-Oh! It's a game that has had a lot of iterations, but it's fundamentally remained the same at its core, much like Magic. Unlike Magic, however, Yu-Gi-Oh! Does not get enough credit, and that bothers me a lot. I hope you guys hear me okay. I don't have anyone in the chat at the moment. Obi was supposed to stream early today, but since he's not, that means I'm gonna play instead. I'm gonna stream. I'm gonna do the thing. I see Kevin, aka K-Magic 101, has a ton of people on his channel right now too. Robbie Hydro, Juju BB, Revlobot, The Dork Knight. A lot of other familiar faces. Streaming NHL. The sports game seems to be a pretty strong niche. Anyway, let's jump into this before I ramble on anymore. Alright, and I'm just doing this single player. I'm not gonna do... Usually I do multiplayer, but I wanna kinda build up my cards. But one of the things, actually, that I would go into is I like the deck editor. We're not gonna get into that just yet. But the card shop. It's separated by the different series. And I like that. This is Zexal, if I'm mistaken. I think Zexal and 5Ds might be the peak. Arc V with the pendulum summons is a little too much for me. Just a little. Ah. Royal Prison. Monsters cannot be special summoned from the graveyard. That's a good one. I'm getting some good cards. You can normal summon one Hazy Flame Monster. Oh, one less tribute. That's really good. What? That's really good. Oh, the Maldolce. Chocolates. Delicious. The Ghost Trick. The Ghost Trick I'm pretty interested in. They have pretty cool effects. You have one Ghost Trick. Spell trap card from your deck to your hand. You can only use this effect. Yeah, let me see what else I get. Now, if you're not into TCGs, this might be boring as hell. Or if you're into TCGs but you don't play Yu-Gi-Oh, this also might be a little boring. I don't know, something about this game that really resonates with me. The way they categorize the cards, the art, the cartoon shows have been great. It's also, I mean, the cartoon shows are pretty much a marketing ploy, but they're fun on their own, to be honest. Ooh, Protective Sanctuary. Like gambling cards like that. Any card that has a dice mechanic is cool. You have to whip out the dice. Like is it Needle Ceiling? No. Needle Wall? I forget which one. One of those. Where each number corresponds to a lane. So placement of the monsters actually matters. Kind of, sort of. Alright, I'm gonna stop that. Let's just play the single player. So I played a little bit of each in the campaign. I really love this game. And this is where it gets retro. You get to play through each of the series. Zexal's about 5-7 years old. I lost track. I mean, Yu-Gi-Oh! The original Yu-Gi-Oh! Go back to 93, 95 maybe? GX was like a 2 to 3 year run. I feel like GX didn't run that long. 5Ds I really liked. I mean, I liked all of them. GX was like the Harry Potter of the series. Anywho, I like the, what did they call it, Synchro Summon mechanic. So I might do 5Ds. Maybe we'll do Zexal. Let's do Zexal. It's a little more recent, but I think it's still more than 5 years old. So I already did this one. Play against the bully, get your friend's deck back. Alright, and then you encounter your friend Astral, who I guess is the Yugi, Yami Yugi of this universe. The real badass. Is his name Flip Turner? Really? I like how this Zexal has a bit of a, like, almost Mega Man feel to it. Kind of a different art direction. I like that. There's always something on the flip side. It's about having fun and doing the best you can. But he's never lost. You know, in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Cartoons, I can't remember a time when the main character lost. I think Zexal may have been an exception. Oh, no, no, no. In 5Ds, Yusei did lose to Jack Atlas right off the bat. And then he upped his skills and got better cards. And he believed in the heart of the cards. I'll use the story deck because I haven't really made my own deck yet. I like how on the loading screen it shows different cards and the flavor text. The humble pot, the trick. 2-star rock with 400 defense, 400 attack. May seem useless, but when you're doing, I think they call it six sizes. The ZYX, XYZ is actually pronounced, like sounded out. Oh, I almost lose. I suck at RPS. One round. Oh, yeah. Yugi did lose against Kaiba in the Kingdom Arc. But it's not something that happens too often. Yeah, and usually when it happens, they cheat. Did they ever lose against, what was it, the Gravediggers? Not the Gravediggers, the Scorpion Brothers, I think it is. Those guys were pretty tricky. Ooh, Slate Warrior. He didn't flip them either. What the heck? All right. So usually it's on rails, but I actually have to play. Okay. The first mission each run walks you through it. So that's cool. It eases you into the mechanics of each series. I'm not familiar with all these cards. I'm a little out of the loop. Oh, I remember this. You got a 1900, that's gonna be rough. At the start of the damage, this card attacks a face-up. Defense monster. You get a special summon. Interesting. From your deck to your hand. I think I'm gonna run that and see what I get. I don't think I have anything useful right now. You can special summon. Unless I do a XYZ summon. What do I have in here? I'm not even familiar with my deck. Can I look at my, Oh, I don't know what XYZ summons I have. Do I have a one star? I'm off to a good start. Let's see. What do you do again? One level one monster in the graveyard. Okay. So maybe if I just... One or low from your hand, then change this... Oh! Here we go! When it's normal summon. Okay. This is what I want to use. Alright. Summon. Yes! Why wouldn't I? Yeah, let's do this guy. And now, special summon. Utopia! Ultimate Four! I think they call it Zexes. That's what a Zexes summon. Actually, I have this card. IRL. Attack with this sucker. Alright. I can't really do anything else, can I? Oh yeah, attack. Duh. Oh, but I will lose. Worth it? No. So cool 3D animations. Did you watch any of the original, anything beyond the original series, like GX or any of that? Now I feel like watching Yu-Gi-Oh! Alright, there's nothing else I can do here. End phase. Do I want to activate the effect of the card? No. Ah, there goes Obi. Never checks to see if I have a party. Just invites me! This is the only annoying thing when it asks you. I know you could disable the ask me how. Do I want to activate the card? No! I'm asking you. Just whoa. I forgot what that does. Monsters with 1500 or more attack cannot declare an attack during each of your standby. Oh, okay. No. Let me see. I don't know why he can't just join my group. Oh, we got two streamers beside me in here. Lagging them currently. Alright, I'll wait for the top. Nope. You drew cards. I broke the party. After the original series, I think Zexal is the most unique in many ways. But if you like that spirit of the original, I think GX is probably the purest, the closest thing. Arc in 5Ds is pretty similar to Yugi. Or Yami Yugi, at least. Alright, so what am I doing? No. I don't want to do that. Activate this one face up attack position. That's pretty useful. I can negate an attack. That's not gonna help me here. What do I have? I have 3 stars. Oh, I know what I can do. That could be useful. Oh, that's a 3-star. So I can put this in attack position. Trigger that. And the next turn put that in XYZ summon. Ooh. Well, I like that. So we'll do that. I feel good about this. I shouldn't put that in defense. It'll be vulnerable. Alright, so I can't attack. Good season. Don't get in trouble with the party. Dark Souls, the board game. That's not a cool idea. What's going on with the party? Oh shit. Start a party and OB join. Is it me that's lagging? I wish I had more people to play board games with. I'm kind of an antisocial bastard these days. And getting the kids to play board games, this family as a whole, it's tough. We got a lot of cool board games. And that's why I gotta play Dark Souls 2. I can't party chat. And this specifies attack, not levels. So I can't really do anything. I'll end my turn. Dark Souls does sound like something that would be cool, would translate well into a board game though. I'm happy to see that there's still a lot of love for the board games. Like, I feel like tabletop gaming is making a comeback. That's cool. I'm just gonna keep them face down. You son of a bitch. This is 1500 or higher. Damn it, they thought of everything. Oh, I could use this Swords are revealing light to reveal the cards. And then what? I need to have something with lower than 1500 attack. Oh, this only has... Maybe if I do this... I think I know what I'm gonna do. Wait, cannot be a single material. Got it. Oh, that sucks. Alright. So we're gonna... Oh, but I can't attack because of the stupid messenger. Poop. Alright, so I have to synchro summon. Alright, summon. 75,000 gold. Not bad. Damn. 1.9 million rays. That's overkill. But, hey, cool. That community is hardcore. That's crazy. I'm gonna put up a Kickstarter for potato salad. Has anyone done that yet? Can I activate the effect of this? No. I just started. There we go. That's effect. 3. Is the one that I want, right? Oh, wait, did I put the right one? Oh, shit, I did it. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Did I mess up somehow? Oh, I need... Wait. How come I can't do that? Three level 3 monsters. Ah, crap. Okay. So I can't do that. Well, poop! You know what? I'm just gonna rage. Sword revealing light. Oh, let me see. I got two things. Yeah, I'll do sword revealing light. What you got? Uh-oh. Oh, is that a locust? Swarm of locusts. Ooh, that. I'm glad I flipped that up. And now he can't use that effect, but he could. He could change it back to face down. So now I know what that is. This could be tough. The conversation's good, so I'm a little like herper derper now. I need something that will take control of these cards. I need one more level 3 homie. What's the base price of the game that they're suggesting? Sounds like it might be one of the pricier games. Lots of little pieces. Oh, You're gonna flip it face down. Former Locust, that's classy right there. I need a level 3. Oh shit, wait, I can. I can use the copycat, right? That's a token. Ooh. Can I take his token? That should count, because it's a level 3. I'm just gonna target one. Oh, it becomes. Oh, it copies your attack and defense. Not the actual stats. Poop. Well, I can use copycat. Target that, destroy it. Yeah. We don't want this form of Locust out. Oh, do I have a level 1 I can use? What to do here? A little cute baby Tiragon. Okay. $113 for the Kickstarter version. It's probably like a deluxe version. Hopefully it'll be cheaper, because that's not going to sell out $120, no matter how hardcore that community is. But you do pay a premium as an early adopter, because you have faith in it, helping bring it forward and all that good stuff. So that makes sense. Alright, I gotta figure out what I'm going to do here. Alright, copycat. And if I copy this guy, I'll be under the limit. Yeah. Effective copycat. No. Yes, those 12,000 people are in a minority of people that spend a lot of money frivolously. And probably don't have a wife that will get angry at them. Most I've thrown in the Kickstarter is maybe $60, maybe $80. And that's because they were friends in the gaming industry. But you know, I'm not knocking it. It's not me. I can't drop that kind of money. Not without thinking a little bit about it. How cheap ass am I gonna say? Alright. How are we gonna do this? How many? It takes 3 level 1 monsters. Wow, that's a lot. Alright, so what we'll do. Oh wait, do I have? Nope. Battle phase? No. I'll attack that. No, why would I wanna negate the attack? That threat's removed. He's gonna put that in attack position, isn't he? Now, what does Zipson do? Can I attack your opponent directly, but still attack? Cannot be targeted or destroyed by your card's effect or. Oh, but it can be destroyed by a monster. Ah, tricky. Okay. There's always a limitation. What else can I do here? by... Well, crap. Finish and my turn here. Hopefully that card down there is not a bad thing. Oh yeah, by all means, you know, pledge for it. You know, I'm not trying to tell anybody not to do Kickstarter stuff. Whoa, what just happened? Your opponent gains. Take control of the equipped monster? Oh hell no! Can I do it on my... Can I put it after the fact? Oh, that's too late. Let's see. Oh shit! I just made his monster invincible. Well, that was dumb. But it can't attack me directly, so that's good. Forgot all about spell speeds. Yeah, might be. He's got me liquor right so far. This messenger of peace is messing me up. But he can't attack. Monsters with 1500 or more attack cannot declare an attack. That applies to him too. So... Man, he's really pulling out all the stops. Okay. This is the story deck. Normally, I would run a lot of spell and trap cards. I'm actually playing out the historic battle. Oh, he killed his own thing. Oh, he took control of all my monsters. Oh, until the end of the turn. Until the end of the turn. Oh. Can't do anything anyway. I think he goofed. Oh, unless he's gonna do a... Okay. He's still negate attacks. This is a quick play card, right? Oh, it's not. So I have to use it on my turn. He's gonna negate the attack, but if he negates the attack, I'm gonna draw him out. That's what I'm gonna do. Hmm. Shooting Star in my graveyard. Well, shit. Alright, if I use that, can't do that because I don't have anything in my hand. So I'm gonna save that. Could that be useless to use right now? Everything in attack position except for that, because then he'll go back into my hand. I got that as a backup. That I completely goofed on. Spell speed, the spell order, combo order, chain order, all that good stuff. Gotta think about that. Alright, he's gonna get that. I'll attack that boy, because he's a bit of a threat. If I can somehow take control of that, that's a 3-star. Just to leave that on the field. Decisions. I also gotta be careful that he doesn't have two of the same kind, and he might be trying to do the XYZ summon. So I gotta prioritize the 2-star. Alright, got it. We have a sound strategy here. No, I don't want to activate the effect. Alright. Nope. And wait, doesn't he get destroyed? When Oh shit. And I completely forgot to. But nah, he would have just canceled the attack. Alright, fine. I'm still good. Deckard! Welcome back! I'm surprised you're up after the crazy night you had, sir. It was weird how you and Harry bumped heads. I still don't understand why it became so confrontational. I think Harry was being a little too sensitive, because you were fine. You were just being you. Oh, he was being too sensitive, but then the way you reacted to it after he muted you for a couple of minutes, that was a little OP. Alright, what's he doing? Nope. Alright, wait for him to commit. Committed. Don't do that. Just let it go, dude. He didn't know that, you know, you're friends with me and Obi. Well, longtime friends with me. Buddies with Obi. Obi should have stepped in, though, and probably just been like, hey, you know, that's just Paul. That's the way he talks. Don't read into it too much. All right. We gotta make something happen here, kids. Reveal one monster in hand. So did I wanna do the 1-star? Oop. Drop my controller. Alright. I'm too excited. To be passive aggressive, that's great. I can't get anything. I'm breaking things over here. There we go. really should get that out. Alright, so I'm gonna do Leviathan. Make sure I can seal this deal. I don't like what that could possibly be there, so I'll probably attack that first. Activate effect. How do you put that back out on the shit? So many decisions. All right, Leviathan is definitely a go. Well, the thing is, your brand of humor is hard to read, and he read it as aggressive. So he was doing what a self-decision mod would have to do. But take it to his job too seriously, who knows? I didn't see any harm in what you were doing. You know, maybe the morgue stuff may have been a little bit much, but she was laughing it off, so it could have been an uncomfortable laugh, I don't know. One of those weird things where you have a certain brand of humor and other people are kind of like, meh. This is old. This is like stuff that used to happen in our clan before. Everybody had their differences. Like, some people couldn't stand Nick because he was too over the top, and everybody's easily offended these days. It's a pain in the ass. The level of that. Meh. I can do that. See, that'd be silly. You gotta know what that would accomplish. Unless I was synchro summoning. What to do? He white knighted you. Alright. Actually get some stuff going here. Alright. How the hell? Oh, safe zone. Because I put the safe zone on it. Wow. I really screwed myself over with that. I sure did. What do you have there? Oh, draw a card. I can't believe I gave him a card to help him out. This is gonna make this battle a lot harder than it has to be. If
So in a way, it renders that card... Whoa, all... Okay. Good. Do I have a level 4? XYZ summon I can do? Oh, I don't. I'll attack that. Yeah, of course I will. All right. Battle first. Let's play it cautiously. My dragon is bad, I guess. We'll lose some life there, but that's alright. I still got the effects from his leech fiend. I got him on the ropes. Oh, they play defensively now. This is gonna be a long match. This was gonna be a short stream, and I guess you guys are gonna get one match, a little banter from me, just because. Whoa. You usually do that? We use dance like Yuta in attack position? Oh shit, son. I don't have too many options right now, to be honest. What to do? I wonder if I could bait him. Oh no, it's level 4! Damn it, and I got nothing. I'm gonna bait him. Well, I can't use this effect, okay. Alright. This has been a slow battle. Oh, right, I can't attack with that because he can't. That's alright. I'm gonna see if I'm gonna test the theory out. I think the way this card works. Oh no, he could do life damage. Why is he even attacking this like copycat? I'm kinda lucky, I guess. Ooh, that is really useful. I should save that for when I can protect it. I could use that on him. That area limiter is really fucking with me. Try this. I'm gonna set it. If the effect will still take place if he attacks it while it's face down. Just, you know, I'll just summon it. If it battles, as long as it battles, it doesn't matter if I attack first. Let's try it. And I get really nerdy when I play this. Alright. I could use fusion material. Summon up to Evil Thorn level 1s. And then I'll have 3 level 1s in the field. Catch 1 XYZ material from this card. 1 level 1 monster. Not really gonna help me here. It'll be vulnerable to Homeboy. I don't think the effect procs. We can tribute this card and put Sub Obi. Oh, and that's when I needed that dude special summon. Oh, it's Comcast sucking right now. Nice. I love Comcast. so terrible. I might end the stream sooner than I thought, again, so I don't know if you still hear me. Oh, why did he... Oh, because he can't die. Attacks. I need to save this one. I can protect them. Then I could. He's gonna flip. I love Yu-Gi-Oh, dude! Oh, it said my stream went offline, so there was a little hiccup there. Maybe it's a Twitch issue, because it said the stream went offline. Just notify me. And then X-Men was acting up. Okay. Dude, I love Yu-Gi-Oh, you kidding me? It's my jam, but I'm in a bit of a impasse right now. I kinda have to save this guy. I did something really stupid in the beginning of this match. Well, actually, I had this battle licked. And I did something really silly. While I put the video up. Oh yeah, there's a Xbox Live Services outage. Good times. I basically helped my opponent by doing this. So I didn't think about the speed of it. And then after the fact, I was like, oops. You live, you learn, but it's a stalemate. Unless he can remove my Leviathan, nothing's gonna happen, because he can't attack directly with that, so the safe zone kind of worked out in my favor. I stalled him to hell. I just gotta keep clearing whatever else he has on the field. And just a bit, yeah. Alright, so... Oh, shit. Why didn't I... Oh, wow, I just completely derped again. What? Oh, it just seems for that turn. That's fine. I derped again. I could have put that out there already. I'm not getting a butt kicked. I'm just doing stupid things. Uh-oh. If that trap fucks with me, I'm screwed. What'd he do? Oh, Book of Moon, no! Are you kidding me? Well played, sir. Well played. I guess we gotta wait a whole other turn, cause nothing else I can do. Book of Moon is great. In my zombie decks, I used to love running that. Ooh, monsters 1500 or more can attack. Wait, he can't attack either. Oh, you dick. Oh. Huh. And now I got a full field. Start the shit out of me. That's what he keeps doing. Okay. Do I have a level 3? I can't put a level 3 out right now. The best bet is to attack that. Make sure I clear it. And then I could do the special summon. Yeah. Let's just do it. One spirit duel. Yeah, I need to make room in my field. Yeah, once I play more with the campaign, I totally wanna. Oh, Panda. Mr. Panda. Okay, this is the game we're gonna play. I'll get you next turn. If I can't attack, then it's not standing. I wanna try that multiplayer though. I got some cards. Alright, Obi blowing me up right now. He had the absolute worst time. I tell ya. There we go. Call of the Haunted. It could be good. Put that. Did he just destroy my... Oh, because I didn't put it in the defense position like a dummy. That's fine. Now I can just attack him. I could attack his life points directly if I just... No, not yet. I'm waiting for him to mess up. I'm a copycat. Damn, somebody would like to play this right now. And I'm like at a standstill. He can't attack anyway. I gotta clear this field. Gigantic does look weird. So does Battle Boy if you think about it. Highly stylized. We'll just call it that. Oh, it's a tuner. I don't have Synchro in my deck. Hold off. Question is, what is he stalling for? Looks like he doesn't have anything. What do I have in my graveyard that I can use Call of the Haunted at on? Yeah, I know I can use that. Nothing really magician. Gaga magician. What other synchro summons I have at this one? Alright, it was for level 4, not rank monsters. Yeah, you mind those synchro. Yeah. Synchro wasn't that big in Zexal, was it? Yes, Obi, I see you. I'm concentrating. This is an epic battle that I've made it more difficult than it used to be. I need to think. Because I can't chew gum and walk at the same time, apparently. See, I wish blustering winds would not count. Like, if Messenger of Peace only read monsters with the original attack 1500 or more, but then it wouldn't be as good as it is. And that's why Messenger of Peace is so good. Yeah, the Zexal with the XYZ numbers, all the numbered monsters and all that stuff. The ninjas were cool. I like the XYZ summons. It adds a whole new layer of depth. Pendulum summons, I'm not really sold on yet. It's a weird mechanic. I don't know. Synchro summon I really like. Fusion summons were the one that I didn't really get into. It's really cool, but it's really complex. You have to kind of build a deck around fusion summons. Remember ritual summons? Some of the coolest monsters were ritual summons, but man, were they bad. I hope you really want to talk to me. Alright. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna summon it normally. We're gonna special summon. Racing John, what is your favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Series? And I feel like I want to go back to Arc B with Zexal. I started Zexal and never finished it, but I liked the way it was going. If there was one I could like binge watch, which would you recommend? I think I got about 10 episodes into Zexal. Don't die, baby. Alright. It's gonna force him to get rid of his messenger piece. Hopefully. And then I got a combo, surprise attack. I will copycat my own monster after I buff him, and then I have 2 3,000 attack monsters. Oh, but one won't be able to attack directly. Do I keep him in attack or defense? I'll put him in defense. I'm talking. I sound robot-y? I don't know. I shouldn't. So Racing John says his is the tie between GX and the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Yeah, they had that spirit of sportsmanship. And like that heart. But GX, I felt, was so short. Like, they had so much potential with GX. They had kind of like that Harry Potter thing going on. A lot of cool feel like, the different rival schools. If you really think about it, like, it was Harry Potter, but with, like, the card game battles. And that was awesome. Jaden Yugi was kind of cocky, but still really cool. Alright. Alright, what do I want to do? Alright. Now you can attack directly. Oh, the bad thing about GX was season 4 was never dubbed. Yeah. Okay, I realized that I had to read the manga, and then I got the subtitle version, but it never came over. Hell yeah, I'm gonna attack him directly. I don't remember how GX ended either. Another good series. A lot of twists and turns. We were talking about it earlier. How often were the Yu-Gi-Oh! Main characters defeated in battle? Oh, he's gonna keep that messenger piece out, okay. Your funeral, buddy. I like how it keeps confirming. Like, are you sure? That might just keep attacking directly. But I'm scared of what that might be down there. If it's a flip effect, that he has to flip himself, he could totally screw me. But I also kind of want to just end this match. I don't need to do it anymore because he's permanently able to do it now. Oh, that's right. He can permanently attack directly. That's why he's such a hard one to summon. What you got there? Ooh. Ah, poison. I'm playing this very conservative, I know. He's gonna just keep that going. What's that face down trap card that he has there? Does he not realize he's about to lose? Hey, look, I got a little chibi ninja girl. Yeah, let me just finish this match, dude. Oh, this is a good card. This is something I could use. You know, just for giggles. I'm gonna do it. Cause I can! Dude, I could totally buff her, and she'll still be able to attack. LOL. Here we go. The overkill. It is happening. Right meow. just for giggles. I have to. This is like completely bad manners. Oh, but I get to use the effect. It would have cleared the field. Yay! I love the unlockables in this game. This is where this game gets really satisfying. All the signature cards you get. And, yeah, they give you cards unlocked. Duel points. This is probably one of the best Yu-Gi-Oh! Games they've come out in the last decade, I would say. If not the best. One of the worst ones. Do you guys remember the Yu-Gi-Oh! On Xbox, original Xbox? It wasn't a bad game. It was just really hard, and they barely gave you any unlockables. Like, building a good deck in that game, like, they started you off all normal cards and, like, spell, really crap spells and traps. Oh my gosh. Dude, wait. The booster packs are awesome, right? I like, you don't, you do like it, right? Oh, Dawn of Destiny, that's the one. Yep. I still have it too. But that game was like, that was a grind fest. This game is very generous with rewards. Let me try it out. Signature card. Just have to make a deck. I like how it unlocks recipes. Oh, is that a Six Samurai deck? It unlocks all the recipes to begin with. Nice. Synchro Suck It. That's right. Gonna fill up my hole. Ooh, I can make that. Black Skull Dragon. Basically, just let's just say I got the fusion of the god cards from them, and one of my favorite cards, Black Skull Dragon. My son likes that card too. I was always a big fan of back in the days when ritual monsters were big. What's this? Oh my god, what deck was it from? Was it the Pegasus deck? Maximilian? The one, the forbidden one. That takes control of one of the enemy's monsters and then assumes them. And instead of if you attack it, instead of him taking damage, the creature he took over takes damage. Destroy instead. That was a cool one. And, what is it? Forgotten one. I forgot what it's called. But anyway, you get the idea. It's like a spider like thing. And the cool thing about that is that, I wonder how that would work with ranked monsters. I like when people take old school stuff and then bring it to like new school. Jupa me pendulum. Something right now. Eventually I'll edit these decks. Legendary Blue Eyes. Flipping Pain. I used to love buying structured decks for Yu-Gi-Oh! I had to calm down because like between me and my son, we were getting obsessed with it. Thousand Eyes Restrict. No, that's the spell card. This is maybe you think about Thousand Eyes Idol and Thousand Eyes Restrict. There's a ritual summon that he had. I like this booster pack. I might have to kick it old school and do like just GX and the original series. Let's talk about the fusion card. No. Isn't that a fusion card? It's a ritual summon, isn't it? You have to use the idol or something to dark ritual. Ah, it's all mixed up in my head now. Ooh, it's the King of the Feral Imps. Once per turn, you can detach one XYZ material for this card. Oh. Cool. Well, let's go kick it old school. Open up a few more packs before we wrap this up. Let's see what Grandpa Muto has. The Relinquished. Thank you. That's the one. DNA surgery. I like that one. I like that. Unlike Magic, where most of the old cards get rendered useless. Yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh does tend to limit and ban certain cards. Previous series. But for the most part, you could go back old school and still compete with the new school stuff. This is really hard. Like if you want 100% first series against these crazy, you know, chain summoning decks like Six Samurai and the Watt decks, where you just fill up the board really fast and just combo after combo, and it'll be rough, but I think you can do it. Ah, Divine Wrath. I like this one. Classics. I think that one's banned in competitive now. Dark Hole used to be the classic. Dark Hole is one I feel like they should bring back as limited if they haven't already. I haven't checked the new rules lately, but I feel it makes sense because sometimes the only answer is Dark Hole. Sometimes the only answer is Harpy Feather Duster. Unity! All these old Scott cards. Tremendous Fire. Remember when Toon decks got really big? I still have a few Toon cards. Mint. Big deal with Toon decks is that, like, Toon cards is that if you got the, what is it, Book of Toon Magic? Toon World. Suddenly all the Toon monsters can attack directly. But then that was a big hoopla because some of the original series didn't have that in their text. So you had to like get the card that said that, oh, any card with Toon in the title can attack your opponent's life points directly. And on a little nuances like that. Re-releasing, republishing cards so that the flavor text is more clear. That happened on any TCG. When it's physical, at least. Wow, look at this old school art. I forgot about this card. Tragedy. That's one I haven't seen played in a while. I wonder if it's still used somewhere. Competitive play. Mother Grizzly. Man, I spent so much time building theme decks, like water decks, zombie decks. Ah. I love Yu-Gi-Oh. Ooh, Secret of the Gallant. Secrets of the Gallant. Like one normal monster control when the selected monster increases battle damage. You have one that's better. That's nice. That's better nice. You might be right about the paying the life points every time you attack with tunes. But it was like, that was like the meta for a while. Everybody wanted a tune deck. It was considered unstoppable. I have tune table of contents. I think I have all the tune cards and I have one tune world field card. But it's other pieces you need to really make it jump, make it pop. Yeah. We're on that memory lane here today on Retro Friday, on Saturday. Oh, Last Wheel! I should have looked at that one. That's a classic. Alright, folks, well, I'm gonna take a break. I'll be back to play Gigantic with you folks if you have an Xbox One. I think we have about an hour or so on the stress test if you wanna jump on there. And I gotta see what Obi wants because he's like nonstop blowing me up. It must be really urgent. So, Obi should be streaming here in a little bit as well. Obi-Wan X2. For now, I will host K-Magic 101, formerly of the West Raider Show. Still part of the gang, but he's kind of doing his own thing. Got a ton of followers. He's got a lot of activity. He's doing his own little sports niche. It's working out for him. I'm glad. He was committed. And, you know, he did it without his team kind of flaked out on him, and now he's doing his solo gig. We appreciate him for that. And hopefully we'll see him more around, more doing gigantic stuff, really collaborating. Teamwork, baby. And again, this game, if you missed it, is Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist on Xbox One. Fantastic. Highly recommended. And I'm YogiZilla. Go visit us on geekyantics.net. I'm YogiZilla everywhere, Xbox Live, Steam, Twitter, all that good stuff. Also, Facebook. We have a Facebook page. Geeky Antics. What's up?